we studied about the structure of the kidney and the role of the kidney in filtering the blood. Okay, now we will study the remaining parts of the human excretory system. The second part is the ureter. Okay, if you remember, okay, we had seen in the diagram this ureter. So here in the diagram, the ureter, the tube like structure that is coming out of the kidney, okay, it is the ureter. Understanding? So ureter is a pair of tube like structure originating from the renal pelvis. Okay, so this is the renal pelvis and joined to it is the ureter, and here also in this diagram also you can see the ureter coming out of the kidney through the renal pelvis. Okay, the renal pelvis collects the urine, okay, and that urine will be going into the ureter. Understanding? And it will be transported in the downward direction to the urinary bladder. So what is the function of ureter? To take the or to collect the urine from the renal pelvis and pass it into the urinary bladder. Understanding? Yeah. Then the next structure is the urinary bladder. Urinary bladder, as you can see in the diagram, is a muscular bag like structure. Okay, and it is present below the ureter. Okay, you can see it is present below the ureter in the lower abdominal region. Basically, the function of urinary bladder is to store urine temporarily. Okay, once the urinary bladder is filled, you will feel the urge of urination, and then once you go for urination, the urine will be removed from the urinary bladder through the urethra. Okay, the last part of the human excretory system, the urethra. Understanding? So coming to the urethra, urethra is a very short, here you can see in the diagram, okay, urethra is a very short muscular tube, okay, and it is present in the lower end of the urinary bladder. Right, now urethra is not always open. Okay, there are sphincter muscles. Which muscles? Sphincter muscles present in the urethra that will be controlling the opening of the urethra, and that will regulate the flow of the urine. Okay, suppose the sphincter muscles were not there, what would had happened? Always the urine would had come out of the urinary bladder. That is why the sphincter muscles control the movement of the urine and it controls the opening of the urethra. Okay, once the sphincter muscles relax, then the urine will be released out of the urinary bladder, and this process of expulsion of urine is called as urination, and it is also called as micturition. So if you get a question in your paper, what is micturition, you should be writing the process of expulsion of urine to the exterior is called as urination or micturition. Understood? So what we have studied over here, we have studied about the human excretory system, and the human excretory system consists of a pair of kidneys, pair of ureter, urinary bladder and urethra. The kidneys will be filtering the blood to remove the metabolic waste, okay, from the blood, right? That blood, that filtrate will be called as urine, which gets collected in the renal pelvis. From the renal pelvis, it is going into the ureter, okay? So the ureter will be carrying the urine from the kidney to the urinary bladder. In the urinary bladder, the urine is stored for a temporary time. Once the urinary bladder is filled, then you go for urination. Okay, the urine is passed through the very small tube like structure present at the base of the urinary bladder, and that is called as urethra. The urethra opening is controlled by sphincter muscles. Okay, the process of expulsion of urine from the body is called as urination or micturition. Understanding? Yeah. Our kidney filters the entire volume of the blood of the body about 400 times every day. So 400 times the blood will be passing through the kidney and the blood will be getting filtered. Okay, so you understand how important the kidneys are, because they will be removing the metabolic waste from our body. Okay, so this way the human excretory system works, right? In the next video, we will be studying about the common disorders of the urinary system, right?